This is ME370 at Portland State University, Lecture 4, Introduction to Intellectual Property. This is Part 3 of the lecture, Utility Patents. Quoting from the USPTO website, we see that a utility patent covers processes, machinery, devices, articles of manufacture, things you make, composition of matter, that could be materials, and any new and useful improvement. So you can create these objects or materials, devices, or you can improve them and get a patent on the improvement. Design patents are focused on the kind of ornamental design that you would see on either article that you'd make or sell. And plant patents are for ways of reproducing plants that don't involve seeds, asexual reproduction. Design patents sometimes involve engineering. The famous Apple-Samsung lawsuits of the last few years have largely centered around design patents. The Samsung phones originally looked exactly like iPhones, and so Apple sued them because they looked like it, not had the same function, although they had similar functions as well. So a design patent is on the ornamental appearance or design, whereas utility patent focuses on the function or capabilities. So we'll focus on utility patents, and they can be granted for a process, a machine, an article of manufacture, a composition of matter, like a material, and as we said before, any improvement in the preceding items. These same criteria don't apply to design and plant patents. So what is patentable? Well, you can patent a method, how to do something. You can patent the device itself. You can patent systems. You can patent business processes or procedures and software. And then you can improve any of those and patent them again. The requirements for a patent as a utility patent is that the patent must be novel. That is, you must be the inventor and it hadn't existed before, so it's not known by others and it was created by you. It has to be non-obvious. So in the first category, it's not invented by you. Couldn't invent the wheel, right? That's been around for a long time and everybody knows about it. Non-obvious means that it can't be just some very simple thing that no one has thought to patent before, such as the process for filling a glass from a pitcher of water. So that process of glass filling is obvious, and it must be useful. The last thing here, last item, rules out perpetual motion machines, for example, things that don't actually work. What can't be patented? You can't patent a law of nature, a physical phenomenon, or abstract ideas. So these need to be concrete, practical things that don't exist in nature. You can't patent literary works, dramatic works, musical or artistic works. Those are covered by copyrights. You can't patent inventions which are not useful, as we've said, no perpetual motion machines. And interestingly, you can't patent something that's offensive to public morality. I'm not exactly sure what would be covered there, but you can't do it. Patent facts then. The patent process is to protect inventions, things or processes that are both new and useful. And they give the legal owner, the holder of the patents, the right to exclude others. So remember, patents exclude our exclusionary rights so that others can't make, use, sell, or offer, as in give away. And patents are valid for 20 years. So that's important. After 20 years, the idea that you've had presumably has given you enough return on your investment in creating it. I'd like to just give you some statistics to give you a sense of the scope of patents. Here is a plot of the history of utility patent applications. Notice that the scale is in hundreds of thousands, so 200,000, 300,000. These are U.S. origin companies or institutions and foreign origin companies or institutions. So this plot shows that they're roughly equal and growing. Utility patents granted show a similar pattern, roughly equal U.S. and foreign origin. These are United States patents. individual countries give patents. So this doesn't mean all the patents in the world. This just means patents granted in the United States. And once again, they're in hundreds of thousands. Design patents are much fewer in number, in the order of tens of thousands. The right scale shows the percentage of all patents. So in 2013, about 8% of all patents were design patents. And plant patents are even smaller in number than design or utility patents. They're in the 0.3%. This shows companies that are responsible for the patents. IBM has historically been issued the most patents. These are patents granted, not applications. So in 2013, IBM was granted 6,788 patents. Note that Samsung has other entities on this list, other divisions of Samsung. So if you added those all together, they would exceed IBM. Also on the list here, number 5, Microsoft, number 10, Google. This is in number of patents granted in 2013, Apple's 12, and the University of California is down there at 80. So look at IBM's number here. 6,788 patents in a year corresponds to 26 per day or 3 per hour. So every 20 minutes in 2013, every 20 minutes of every workday, on average, IBM was granted a patent. This is the front page of a patent that was awarded to Professor Weislogel and Professor Thomas, and working with a colleague, Dr. John Graff at NASA, they developed a shape of a tubing system that helps separate multiphase flows in zero gravity. And you can sort of see the appearance of a patent drawing in the bottom and all this nomenclature. Patents are quite dense to read. Here's a patent that was granted by someone or to someone in Portland. And he contacted me last year. This is for a guitar tuning mechanism, and asked one of our students to help make this device.